I had taught heat and mass transfer for a number of years, and I guess I was really dissatisfied with the textbooks that we had to work with at that time. So I thought about it, and I approached Dave and told him what I had in mind and what I was looking for in a co-author, and would he be interested? And he said yes, and so that would have been in 1974. And we then together worked for 6 years in developing the final product that would be the first edition of the book.
They made a perfect team because they had a bit of a contrast. Frank would say, run hard, run fast. And Dave would say, sometimes look around too.
Over the 6 years that we worked on putting out the first edition, we spent more time in that heat transfer conference room than the entire heat transfer faculty combined over their entire careers. We lived in that conference room. Particularly if you're proofreading, boy, after an hour, hour and a half, you've got to get your mind on something else. We loved the look and the feel of the book. Between the covers, that book did everything we wanted it to do. And boy, it was an instant success.
The best.
Yeah, good book.
The Bible of heat transfer.
The best-selling and the most adopted textbook.
Anybody who is even touches heat transfer would know the book Incropera and DeWitt.
So I've used it so much, I could probably tell you which page number what's on in some ways.
I know you know how to do that because I saw it in Incropera and DeWitt's book.
It's a legend, not only across the U.S., but across the world.
It has been translated in other languages and adopted overseas.
I had my undergraduate education in China, and we used that book. We used a translation of the first edition.
It becomes part of people's shelves, and anytime you need to practice heat transfer, you kind of go back and say, let me see if there's an example problem like that in Incropera and DeWitt.
When you look at the problems, you see Dave. He concocted a lot of problems.
He did almost all of the problems, homework problems. Amazing, and they were good homework problems.
Not only was it probably the best book in heat transfer ever written, and there have been many, but it just was so thorough, so carefully done. It just truly, I think both of them put their heart and soul into it.
It was a work that we were very proud of. He would ask the question, well, why are we doing this, Frank? Dave had a term that he used. I want to do something that influences men's and women's minds. He wanted to do something that would have a real impact on how young people learn the subject of heat and mass transfer. And you know, that's always been my objective too. And we felt that the book and its subsequent editions were true to that objective that he had had.